writing, sleeping, and even saying hello? Before I came here, I had no idea Americans did this differently than Germans. Hallo, Servus, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Felicia, and I'm a German living in Cincinnati, Ohio. So, some of you may already know this, but I was born and raised in Germany, in Munich to be precise. I went to high school there and to college, and I didn't come to the US until 2016, when I came here for an exchange semester during my undergrad. After that, I returned to get my master's here, and now I'm here as a permanent resident. So, I've been living here for about 3 years now, and during those 3 years, there have been a lot of occasions where I was really confused because I noticed that my American friends do certain things differently than me and what I was used to from Germany. Some of those things I noticed pretty soon after just being here for a few weeks, but then other things I didn't actually find out about until after a year. For this video, I tried to limit my list to 5 things. But I actually have a lot more to share on this topic, so if you guys like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and let me know whether I should make a part 2 on this. So here are 5 things that I noticed Americans do differently than Germans. For some reason, Americans have different handwriting than Germans. And this is something that I didn't really notice until like a year after I first came here, because whenever I saw someone's handwriting, which is kind of rare nowadays, it never occurred to me that that's how all Americans did it. I just assumed that that's that particular person's way of writing things. But no, turns out that all Americans do it like that. And I'm glad that I found out, because now I always try to write the same way that Americans write, especially when I fill out forms or something, because I want to avoid any kind of confusion, especially with my phone number and my address, because these differences especially regard numbers. Here are a few examples. In Germany, this is how I always wrote my 1, with this long line starting at the bottom, and I think this is how most Germans do it, or some make a slightly shorter line. Americans, on the other hand, write their 1 like this, or they write it like this with a serif. The 4 looks like this in my handwriting, but I just learned last week that apparently some Americans do it differently. I teach German to first graders once a week, and they actually complained about it to me and told me that this is how you properly write a 4. I feel like I haven't seen that difference a whole lot though, so to my American viewers, how do you guys write a 4? Then Germans usually write the 7 like this with a line through the middle, while a lot of Americans just write it like this without one, which can be kind of confusing to a German because this kind of looks like a German 1. And last but not least, a lot of Americans complain that the German 9 looks like a G. I've heard this so many times because Germans write their 9 like this, while Americans do it like this. And that's how I try to do it now too, especially when I write something that other people are supposed to read. So just an example, this is how I write my birth year when I'm in Germany, and this is how I write it when I'm in the US. Now, regarding letters, most Germans write their Z with a line in the middle, while a lot of Americans don't do that. And a lot of Americans write their capital I's or J's with a serif, while Germans usually do it like this most of the time. Or we may even write it in a completely different way, because all Germans learn cursive in school, and from what I remember, it was also mandatory to use it until at least 4th grade, or it may have been even longer. After graduating, Germans usually don't use cursive anymore, but a lot of them keep certain elements from cursive in their everyday handwriting. And it's often the capital letters, so a capital I would look like this, which could be kind of confusing if a German writes something in English and then the word I always kind of looks like a J. Or some people use the cursive capital K, L, or other letters. And related to this, there's another everyday difference regarding school. I'm not sure if this is the same in all Germany, but when I went to school, we only used a pencil in 1st grade, and then starting in 2nd grade, we were required to use a fountain pen all throughout elementary school. And then I think in 5th or 6th grade, we were allowed to use a ball pen. But pencils weren't really something people would write with in school, and filling out an exam with a pencil is actually usually not allowed because it's hard to read and it's also easy to manipulate afterwards. In the US, however, paper, most students write with pencils in school, even on exams, but I'm not sure if that's something that's required in school or if it's just very common to do. And one thing that I had also never seen before I came to the US is this little thing. And this is something that you'll find in almost all American classrooms, even college classrooms, and it's a pencil sharpener attached to the wall. The second thing that Germans and Americans do differently a lot, and of course this doesn't apply to all Germans and all Americans, but it's definitely a pattern that you can observe a lot, is how people say hello and goodbye to each other. In general, I would say that Americans are more individual than Germans. Maybe you've heard about this distinction between individual cultures like the US and collective cultures like they have it in a lot of Asian countries. And while both the US and Germany are considered to have individual cultures, I would say that Americans are even more on the individual side of the spectrum than Germans. And that's something that you can absolutely see with how people greet each other and say goodbye. Americans seem to be a lot more casual about those things. They often just say a quick hello, hi, what's up, and then when they leave, see ya, bye, and then they're already gone. And this is something that I especially noticed on campus back when I was still a student. German students love to walk around in groups, and when they have to split up, they'll often say something like, have a great time in your next class, and I'll see you tomorrow in blah 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 class, or something specific like that. So here in the US, whenever I was walking in the same direction as a classmate I was friendly with, I would naturally walk with them. And sometimes it happened that that person wouldn't even realize that I tried to do that because they weren't used to it, or they would just randomly say bye in the middle of the conversation. So when you walk together and talk about something and then have to split up, in Germany, people would stop and try to wrap it up as quickly as possible and then say goodbye, while in the US, it often happens that people don't even stop and just say goodbye in the middle of the conversation and walk away. And you'll notice the difference even more when you're in a social group, like at someone's birthday dinner, for example. In Germany, when a new person joins the group, it's common that they go around and say hi to everyone individually, often by hugging them, while in the US, it's often just a quick hi to everyone. And it's the same with goodbyes in Germany. If the group isn't too big, you'll say goodbye to every single one and again hug them in a lot of cases. Neither of the two behavior patterns are better or worse in my opinion. They both have their pros and cons. But if I had to describe this to a German, I'd probably say that Americans kind of get together and separate almost like a cloud of mosquitoes in a pretty loose way, while in Germany there seems to be more commitment involved. This is somewhat related to the last point. It's about answering and hanging up the phone. A lot of people in Germany answer their cell phones the same way they would answer their landline phones, by saying their name. Often their last name or their first and last name. So they'll just answer their phone and say Schmidt. No hello or anything else. I mean, this is mostly when you don't know who's calling, obviously, but I've never heard an American answer their phone with just their name. I mean, I know that for landline phones, Americans would kind of do that and go like, Smith Residence, Felicia speaking. But I'm not even sure if people still do that now, I only know that from movies. When it comes to hanging up, I feel like Americans often sound super short and almost kind of mean. Which is funny because Americans overall are a lot more friendly and open than Germans. But when it comes to hanging up the phone, Germans often do the same spiel as we do in real life, where we sum things up first, then we exchange good wishes, then we talk about when we'll see each other again, and then we'll sing tschüss, or another way of saying goodbye into the phone, which is also the way that Germans say tschüss in real life, by the way. We always sing it, and that's also how I do it in my videos, actually. In the US, a lot of people just say bye in this kind of angry sounding tone, and I know they don't mean anything bad by it, it's just their normal tone, but compared to the rest of the culture, it really kind of threw me off in the beginning. Especially when you hear someone talking to their mom or something and it's really loving, and then they go, "Oh, thank you, love you too, mom. Okay, bye." Definitely a difference. Germans and Americans sleep differently, which probably sounds kind of weird at first because don't all people sleep the same? But no, apparently they don't. First of all, there are a lot of differences between German and American beds, but the thing that threw me off the most in the beginning was this whole tucking in thing. Americans really, really, really like it to tuck in their sheets or their comforter into the bed, like underneath the mattress, and then sleep in it like in a cave or something. To Germans, that's just such a nasty habit. We literally hate that collectively as a society because we actually like it the other way around. We love wrapping our comforter around our feet and all around ourselves. So the first thing we do when we see a bed with tucked in sheets, we'll pull them out. And this is actually very well known in the hotel business. I've heard that a lot of housekeepers here hate German tourists because we always mess up the bed entirely and then they have to tuck in the sheets again and then we'll just pull them out again the next day. And even though I've been here for a while now and I have adapted in a lot of different ways to the US, I honestly don't think I'll ever start liking that. Americans even say "I'll tuck you in" to a kid when they bring them to bed. And there isn't even a German translation for that, for tuck in that sense. So that's how much this isn't a thing in Germany. A few other things about sleeping habits is that German beds usually have a slatted frame with a mattress on top instead of a box spring. And they're often a lot lower than American beds. We usually have comforters and pillows with duvet covers that we can take off and wash regularly instead of quilted comforters or a blanket with sheets. A lot of Germans use square pillows. I personally don't, but a lot of Germans do. And big double beds usually have two twin mattresses in the big frame, and a lot of couples have separate comforters instead of sharing one. And regarding that double mattress and double comforter thing, I personally definitely prefer the American way. Now, before I share the last point with you guys, this is for everyone who wants to learn German or another second language. I have a voucher code for everyone who doesn't want to invest years in this, but who wants to learn a language really quickly. The online language school Lingoda is doing this amazing thing called Sprint that helps you speak a language confidently in just 3 months. And you'll also have the chance to get a 100% cashback. So this is not only a great motivation to follow through with it, but also a really nice way to save money. They offer German, English, business English, French, and Spanish. And all of their instructors are native speakers. And I'm sure all of you who have tried to learn a language before know how important it is to practice with a native speaker. And it's also amazing to be able to learn from them how the language is actually used in everyday life. I've actually checked out one of their German classes before, and I was really impressed with how well the lesson was structured, but more importantly, with how well the students spoke German after just a few weeks. Their grammar and pronunciation was amazing, and most people that I know that have taken a year of German in college or several years in high school don't even sound that good. Lingoda offers classes every day of the week, every time of the day, so you'll definitely find classes that fit your schedule so you can do it during lunch break or after work, on the weekends, etc. And there's only an average of 3 students per class, so your teacher will definitely have enough time to address your personal needs and questions. There are classes for every level, complete beginner, intermediate, or advanced learner, and they also added new optional quizzes for their German and English classes to help you track your progress even better. This starts on April 8th and ends on July 6th. And you can either do the super sprint, which means that you'll do 30 classes a month for 3 months, and you'll get a 100% refund if you attend all of those classes, or you do the sprint and attend 15 classes a month for 3 months and get a 50% refund. So if you're interested, make sure to sign up before March 24th and use the link in the description box below. And of course, don't forget to use this voucher code. You'll have to pay a 49 euro deposit to secure your spot because spots are limited, but with this code, you'll get a 10 euro discount on that. And as I said, if you attend 30 classes a month for 3 months, Lingoda will refund your tuition fee in full. Now let's get back to the topic. So the last thing that I have on my list of things that Germans and Americans do differently is that a lot of Americans wear street shoes inside the house. This varies from household to household, obviously, but overall, it seems to be a lot more common in the US to wear your shoes inside and not take them off when you enter the house. And that's something that's very different in Germany. In most German houses and apartments, you'll see a whole lot of shoes in the entrance area because most Germans take off their shoes as soon as they get into the house. And in some apartment buildings, you'll even see the shoes outside in the shared hallway because people don't want the dirt inside their their apartment, and there's also often a lack of space. So wearing street shoes inside the house is very rare in Germany, but instead, Germans love to wear slippers inside, Hausschuhe. Almost every German has at least one pair, and as soon as they come inside, they'll immediately switch from street shoes to Hausschuhe, slippers. For guests, a lot of Germans have a few extra pairs of guest slippers, and as a kid, I also had a pair at kindergarten and then later at elementary school. So we would change into slippers before we entered the classroom. And when I went to a friend's place as a kid, it was very common to bring your own pair of slippers with you to wear at their place. And this is something where I guess I was never fully German at heart because I never really liked that concept and I stopped wearing slippers pretty soon when I grew up. I mean, I like to wear thick socks, but I don't really like wearing shoes inside the house at all. And if I do, it'll be my street shoes. So when I came to the US, I really felt like I was in good company here. That was the list for today of things that Germans and Americans do differently. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you'd want me to make a part two about this, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. And of course, I want to hear what you guys think about these topics that I mentioned and if you have maybe made any similar experience with them. So if you have anything to share, make sure to leave me a comment below. If you like what I do on my channel, don't forget to subscribe for free and also activate the bell to get notified whenever I upload a new video. Follow me on Instagram and I hope I'll see you next time. Tschüss!